Hi everyone, I'm Kgaugelo and I'm an engineer. Just to put some perspective into my testimony, I started my degree in 2006 and I completed in 2013. So all of you that are busy starting to calculate, let's make it easy for you. That was 8 years that I was in tax. And needless to say, it was a bit challenging. I started off studying electrical engineering and moved to electronics engineering. Probably one of the worst things I could have done, but anyway, it was quite interesting. Some of the biggest challenges that I faced were financial issues. So if you can imagine trying to get a four-year degree over 8 years, my bursary cut me off at some point. And I had no idea what I was going to do, but you know, the Lord is faithful. I just had a company approaching me saying, hey, how we want to pay for all your fees. And it was done just like that. The depths of the seas and the thing that stands out the most for me is the time that I had to look for a job. And I think you can imagine that if having been in the university for 8 years, now trying to look for a job, you wonder, will any company want me? Will I have to settle for whatever company that comes along, or what will happen? And you know, I really saw God's hand in that whole situation of looking for a job. So I went for interviews at one of the Fortune 500 companies, and I was interviewing with some really hectic people that were telling me I've aced my degree, people that were telling me I have honors or masters in this and that. And can you imagine my excitement when I got the call to say, hey, how you've gotten the job? You know, at that point in time, I did not even know what to say or what to do, because I was interviewing with such other hectic people. But it doesn't end there. After getting my job, I had to relocate to Europe for a year. And in that year, I've been able, through my job as well, to travel around a couple of European countries and also to the US, and learn so much and learn so much about people, about a different place altogether. Before then, I had not even thought of living anywhere outside of the country or even going to visit anywhere outside of the country. But you know, through this opportunity, I got afforded that chance to really have a different kind of perspective about things, and I enjoyed that thoroughly. So now I'm back in the country and currently working as a systems engineer. And I'm still marveled at how God has blessed me, because I work with some very experienced people, people that have tons of years of experience in the industry that I'm in. The message that I have for you guys is never sell yourself short because you're looking at yourself through your own eyes. All those dreams that you had, regardless of what happens in university, maybe you fail a couple of modules. I failed a lot, but hopefully you don't fail. But should anything happen, maybe you're struggling financially to get through, just remember the dreams that you have, and nothing can stand in the way. Don't let anything stop you, and just keep on pushing, and you will get through by God's grace. So what got me through all this turmoil, this whole 8 years, was the relationship that I have with the Lord. I think it's very important to keep a very close relationship with the Lord. I had to relocate to Amsterdam for a year, and things are done really differently in Europe. So while at Elim you still have the opportunity to come together every Sunday and there are events and you can do whatever you want, you can be involved in the church to whatever level you can be involved in. It was totally different for me when I got to Amsterdam. Firstly, it was very difficult to find a church because now nobody goes to church. So I had to look for God in places that I never even thought of looking for Him in those places before. And I think it was important that I had a very strong and steady relationship with the Lord, because that pulled me through, right? As well, I think knowing the plans that God has for me, having had those million chats with the Lord, asking Him, God, what is my way forward, right? What is your plan for me, and how do I get there? And as much as maybe I did not get straight answers then, just knowing that the Lord had a plan for me kept me going each and every single day. So I encourage you guys to stay rooted in the Lord. Keep on doing your quiet times in the morning. Keep praying. Keep reading the Word. Keep asking the Lord, God, where do you want me to go next? And you will be really amazed at what the Lord has in store for you. God is done, and lift Him up higher, higher.
Can we just right now just sing out our praise to Jesus? Sing out in your own words, your own way. Lift Him up, lift Him up, lift Him up.
Elim alumni.